The Introduction by Nahum Tate. Fame, sound thy trump, all ranks of mortals call, to share a prize that will enrich 'em all. You that with sacred oracles converse, and clearly would mysterious truths rehearse, on soaring wings of contemplation rise, and fetch discoveries from above the skies. Ethereal tea, your notions will resign till you yourselves become almost divine. You statesmen who in storms the public helm would guide with skill and save a sinking realm, tea, your Minerva, shall suggest such sense, such safe and sudden turns of thought dispense, that you, like her Ulysses, may advise and start designs that shall the world surprise. You pleaders, who for conquest at the bar contend as fierce and loud as chiefs in war, would you amaze and charm the listening court? First to this spring of eloquence resort, then boldly launch on Tully's flowing seas and grasp the thunder of Demosthenes. You artists of the Aesculapian tribe, would you, like Aesculapius's self, prescribe, cure maladies and maladies prevent? Receive this plant from your own Phoebus sent, whence life's nice lamp in temper is maintained, when dim, recruited, when too fierce, restrained. You curious souls who all your thoughts apply the hidden works of nature to descry, why veering winds with varied motion blow, why seas in settled courses ebb and flow, would you these secrets of her empire know? Treat the coy nymph with this celestial dew, like Ariadne she'll impart the clue, shall through her winding labyrinths convey, and causes skulking in their cells display. You that to Isis's bark or cam retreat, would you prove worthy sons of either seat, and all in learning's commonwealth be great? Infuse this leaf, and your own stream shall bring more science than the famed Castalian spring. Would you, O music sons, your art complete, and all its ancient miracles repeat, rouse revelling monarchs into martial rage, and when inflamed with softer notes assuage, the tedious hours of absent love beguile, charm care asleep, and make affliction smile? Carouse in tea that will your souls inspire. Drink Phoebus's liquor and command his lyre. Sons of Apelles, would you draw the face and shape of Venus, and with equal grace in some Elysian field the figure place? Your fancy, warmed by tea, with wished success, shall beauty's queen in all her charms express. With nature's rural pride your landscape fill the shady grotto and the sunny hill, the laughing meadow and the talking rill. Sons of the Muses, would you charm the plains with cheerful lays or sweet condoling strains, or with a sonnet make the valleys ring to welcome home the goddess of the spring? Or would you in sublimer themes engage and sing of worthies who adorn the age? Or with Promethean boldness would aspire to catch a spark of the celestial fire that crowned the royal conquest, and could raise Juverne's boyne above Scamander's praise. Drink, drink inspiring tea, and boldly draw a Hercules, a Mars, or a Nassau.